Hey everybody, I'm Chanel Herlin here for the New Music Buzz at the Vista Theatre for the Range 15 premiere. The red carpet is about to start, so let's check it out.
Good afternoon, Mr. Best.
What's Range 15?
It's a fallback point for an ELE.
Shit. I'm not gonna leave the fate of the world to you fuck-offs.
I prefer my guy.
Keep your ears buttered up, blast that fire to the range.
So why are we going to Range 15?
That's where the scientists are and we have the cure.
Stay away from the glass.
If this was a zombie movie, you'd be getting ripped through that glass right about now.
This is a zombie movie!
Look, Matt, sometimes things can look pretty bleak.
How is it working on this film, Range 15?
It's different from other projects because the only people on the project are people that want to do it. You know, and in Hollywood, you get that douchebag act, Gary Busey, who's just doing it for the paycheck, Gary Busey. And, you know, no one wants to work with him. He's miserable. But no, everyone wanted to be part of it. Everyone was happy. The background, it didn't matter how hot it was or how much makeup they had on, they were happy to be there. And from the beginning to the fundraising to the theaters, 241 theaters and counting that it's going to play at, that doesn't happen for independent film without a lot of love and support behind it. And, you know, in a time where we're so divided, it's nice to see everyone get behind veterans and the military and America.
Yes, America. And now, what attracted you to the script? What brought you onto the project initially?
I think Ross recommended me, and then Jared called me. And they're like, oh, you know, the script. And they sent me the script, and I read it, and I loved it. I'm a comedic actress, and I like messed up. I'm messed up in real life. I'm probably not acting. I'm probably only acting when I have to be serious or I have to do CSI or something. I'm like, serious. You know, I love messed up humor. That's me every day. And hopefully I hold my own. I know it's a military comedy, but I'm excited. I haven't seen it yet. I mean, I was there, but I haven't actually, like, seen the film. I've missed all the other screenings, so I'm kind of excited.
So are you able to just sit back and relax and enjoy yourself on the screen, or are you quite critical of your performance?
It's weird. Everyone has an idea of what they look like and what they sound like, and I'm sorry about my voice in advance. I've heard my voicemail. You know, but it's weird to see yourself. It takes you out of your body. I like it when I can hear people laugh at something I've said. You know, the times where I've had premieres and I make people laugh, that's the best feeling. That's what I'm here for. I'm like, oh, like I am what I love to do, and kind of excited. You know, it might be grossed out, it might be laughing, there might be tears, there might be throw up, I don't really care, as long as it's entertaining.
Great, and do you have friends and family here tonight supporting you?
I don't, Mom. And I'm not bitter at all, but I have lots of friends, and friends can be like family. They're the family you choose to have. And I've been lucky, of the 5 years I've done acting, to have really good friends and peers, and just, you know, even if you only see them once every 2 years, you feel like, you know, you've been through, you know, maybe like the military, you've been through something with them, and you just, it's always a good feeling. And there's a lot of people here tonight. I know, it's like a birthday party I never got.
So tell me about the film. What is your involvement?
I play the Colonel's daughter and one of the very many love interests of Matt Best. And there's a keys scene. That's about it.
And what was it like working with Matt?
Well, I know him, so pretty normal.
No starstruck moment there.
Oh, God, no.
And what was it like working on the film?
It was nerve-wracking. It's the first film I've ever been in, but it was a lot of fun. Everybody was very down to earth, and I got to meet a lot of stars from my childhood that I was starstruck by.
So tell me, Russ, this is an incredible project, and to see such an amazing support here tonight, are you able to just relax and enjoy your film, or are you still quite critical of your work?
Yeah, no. I smoked a ton of weed in the parking lot, so I feel great. Like, I feel really great. I love these lights. Like, yeah. No, it's great. You look fantastic.
Oh, you look fantastic. Yeah, I'm loving that gray cap.
Thank you so much. It was about 98 degrees today. No Nick Lachey, pun intended, but I was really sweating. So I threw a fucking, I went Ken Griffey Jr. on it.
Okay.
Okay. Threw the hat on backwards.
Oh gosh, well at least it's cooled down a bit now for you guys to watch the movie in a bit of peace.
A nice breeze is picked up. A nice Australian breeze is picked up. So
I'm not from Australia, but nice
neither.
Try.
Me neither. I'm not either. Well, who says we can't both love the same continent?
Exactly.
Continent love is blind. It really is.
Now tell me, what was it like working with your cast during the process of the film?
They were amazing. Yeah, they were amazing. Whenever you get to work with U.S. military veterans, I don't want to sound shitty or cliche about it, but they're just harder workers than like normal people. So they're never late. They're always on time. They always want to rehearse. Like, it's a blast. I wish everybody was like that. But usually everybody's lazy and they're like, "Fuck, I want your sandwich. Why is your sandwich bigger than mine? Why is your trailer bigger than mine? I still want that sandwich." And then they'll go back to the sandwich. And you're like, "Jesus, man, lay off the sandwich." Like, I get it. You know?
I mean, now, what is up next for you? Now that this film is done, Range 15, what's happening next?
Holy cow. So I wrote a book that came out last year. It was a bestseller called A Night She Cries While He Rides a Steed. It was the first ever romance novel for dudes. So I have to write the sequel to that. And then probably, more than likely, a sequel to this.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we expect a movie from the book that you're writing?
I hope. That's a big budget. That's a really big budget. And I got to get a lot more famous. So if this does well opening weekend, yeah, maybe. If not, probably not.
Well, it looks like it's going to do incredibly well. So congratulations and really nice to meet you.
I really appreciate it. It was nice to meet you too.
My mom's getting overwhelmed here.
Oh, that's wonderful. So tell me, as an audience member, what can we expect from the film at Range 15?
That'd just be a good cutaway. That'd be a good cutaway. A lot of intense comedy, you know? Like, we push the levels on the comedic aspect of this film, and I think that it's going to be a lot of fun and a lot of what people need in their life, you know?
And what was the process like from beginning, pre-production, all the way now till post-production? Lots of ups and downs, or was it pretty smooth sailing? How would you describe it?
I think anybody that's been in the production business knows it's a grind. We started this from day one. We wrote the process. Cheers, buddy. We wrote the film. We edited the film. We produced the film. So it's a grind, but at the end of the day, it made the film what we wanted it to be, which is kind of a narrative for what veterans should be and how our culture is. So we're super excited about it.
First of all, tell me about this picture.
Well, this is that's hopefully my best friend, The Rock. I love you. We should be together. Friends though. No, I love the dude. I think he's an inspiration. I thought the outfit was outstanding and I wanted to try and replicate it, so I feel like I did a good job.
You did a brilliant job. The jeans, the moon bag, the shirt, and the chain.
I missed the watch, yeah, but we're good.
Okay, so talking about music, how do you get in the zone for a day on set? Do you listen to music to pump you up?
I actually do, man. I'm one of those guys that if you see a lot of my social media, I always have a headset in somehow, some way. So depending on the mood, right? Like depending on the scene, what we're doing, I'm either going to listen to soft music, some loud music, whatever it is. And we had a lot of awesome talent donate some music to us for this film. And it's been insane. I mean, guys like, the Hustle Standard, they donated some music for us. I mean, guys like a TMR, the Marine rapper. Like, we had so many people, like, just donate music for the film that worked perfect for what we were trying to do. So it's been a fun ride with the music itself. Yeah.
And what was it like working on set with such an incredible cast?
Yeah, it's a blessing. I mean, like I said, like most of us, this is the first time we've ever done anything like this. So for us, we're just kind of soaking it in and hope that we can replicate it down the road, because this is something we produced ourselves. I would love to do it again. It was a blast. It was a blast.
Can you tell me about your character in Range 15? What is he like?
I'm playing myself. I play a character called the Celebrity. Okay. They can see they change it. There were a guy, I think he makes a point of meeting me. And then we both take our clothes off, sit in the jacuzzi. Oh, sorry, wrong film. No. So we do a little dialogue together, and then he sees me at some restaurant or some event. It was such an honor to be in this. I'm just cracking up. Such an honor to be in this movie. My whole family was all veterans. My mom was in the OSS, and the Office of War Information during World War II. She was a spy. Yeah, my dad, all my uncles, they all fought wars. You know, I have two Purple Hearts. One died, one survived, but we had wounded his whole life, you know.
Yeah. Now, I'm just going to backtrack a little bit to your joke in the jacuzzi.
You British?
No, I'm South African. Close.
I made up the whole thing about jacuzzi never happened.
I know, but Rafi, how many...
I'm not with that team yet. I'd want a jacuzzi with you, perhaps, but not...
Oh, no!
Okay, but I want to ask you, this is my question. How many adult films have you been in, Ron? How many adult films have you been in? Tell me.
I think this is funny. I don't care how cute a guy is. I'm not going to be in a jacuzzi with a guy. I'm not batting for that team quite yet. You never know. I get a little older and can't get the girls, you know. That guy's Harry Pina looks pretty good. You know, you never know.
Oh, my gosh, you're hilarious. Now, we are a music channel.
Not a boring interview.
No, my question was, how many adult films have you been in, Ron?
I have the world's record. But I have another one. I've been about 2,000 and over a couple of thousand adult movies. 33-year career. But also, no one knows this. I've been in 56 music videos. MTV, VH1, YouTube. I have the world's record. No one's even close. I've been in more music videos than Michael Jackson, everybody.
Well, we are a music channel.
Yeah, I had one song that was a hit single called Freak of the Week with me, DJ Polo, and Ice-T on the backside. And it was called Freak of the Week. It was on Billboard 27 weeks.
Hey, man. Well, last
manly
then, Matt. Ron.
We hug like manly men.
Oh, you don't want to hear what he just told me earlier, though.
Oh, about sharing a jacuzzi with a guy. Hey!
What's up, buddy?
Man. Good, nice to see you there.
Fabulous harmonica player, I hear.
I'm not bad.
Wait,
hold that up.
Do you have a tear?
Want to hear an Irish song, Danny?
Want
to do Danny Boy?
Oh, that was
even bring the British folks.
Yes.
But you gotta give me a hug though. When you do.
Okay, I'll give you a hug. Let's go.
See if she cries when I play the song.
Okay.
It's Danny Boy. It's Irish song.
Oh,
but not yet. Here's the good part.
My goodness, that was beautiful.
It's a lovely song.
Oh, thank you.
Hi, it's Ron Jeremy, known as being a harmonica player and an actor,
and
a violin player and a piano player. Go to Kid Rock's video, Cowboy. I'm the guy on the piano.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Cowboy, I'm the guy playing when Josie and Gary Coleman duke it out, and I'm the guy on the piano. Because Kid Rock knew I played piano, so I played piano in that video. Yeah.
And can we say together, you have just been buzzed to the camera. One,
okay.
Two, three.
You have just been buzzed.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you. The red carpet is almost done. Range 15 is about to start. We've had quite an interesting night with some very interesting actors. I'm Chanel Herlin, and you have just been buzzed.